So to continue learning about many different amazing aircrafts and everything from militaries from around the world, we look at two really unique fighters, one Chinese in Pakistan and the other one originating from the country of India. And with that, we look at the differences between the JF-17 and the HAL Tejas and find out if there is a big difference, which one is better, and perhaps which one is worse. How's it going, everybody? What's up? Dave Wapple here. Welcome back to FTD Facts. If you are a reoccurring sort of subscriber, if you're new here, well, welcome to FTD Facts for the first time. So today, yes, we are looking at fighters. Now, I love learning about different types of military aircraft from around the world. It's just really cool to learn, you know, different specs and kind of what other countries have to offer. But the thing is, these two fighters, for the people from these countries, they might be very proud of them because, yeah, they originated pretty much from Pakistan and India. Also, this is part of our military playlist. I'm going to put them in the cards in this video. Also, they'll be in the description box below. And at the end of the video, if you want to learn more just about militaries. Trust me, guys, we've done a lot of stuff on militaries. It's really cool to kind of like get your mind out there. You know what I mean? So now let's take a look at these single engine, single seat, multi-role combat aircrafts. Both of them are classified as modern fighters. As for which generation they are, it's really hard to say because there's nothing really down on paper. However, for the JF-17, although it is an older fighter, many people consider that to be a 4-plus generation fighter. And as for the HAL Tejas, because it's very recent, I could see it as a 5th. However, keep in mind, just because it's higher up in the numbers, that doesn't make it a better aircraft. That's not true. So the JF-17, it has a really interesting history. Now, its first flight was in August of 2003. However, it wasn't introduced for military function until March 12th of 2007. Basically, you had this fighter being made by two different companies, one from Pakistan and one from China. However, there are many different reasons why the two joined together to work on this fighter. First of all, there's a bit of an operational history. I mean, Pakistan has used Chinese fighters before. But however, at that time, one of the biggest things was that these two countries wanted to produce a fighter that was comparable to the Western fighters, but was much cheaper to develop. In 1989, China was working with a US company to develop what was known as the Super 7, which was basically an upgraded version of the Chengdu F7. Pakistan was also part of this program, which was known as Project Sabre. However, unfortunately, the US company had to pull out due to the fact that there were heavy sanctions on Pakistan, and there were heavy sanctions on China as well. And what I mean by the fact that this fighter has a really interesting history is these sanctions were put in place because of the famous Tiananmen Square incident, which is where you get this famous photo of the man standing in front of the Chinese tanks that were brought in to break up the protest. Obviously, the United States didn't like that at the time, so they said, no, we're not doing this anymore. However, by 1999, China and Pakistan had joined and signed a contract, and that is when work really began. Now, in today's world, there is really not an actual number of how many of these are flying around. They do say that there's over 100 plus. I think it's somewhere around 120, somewhere around there. And when it comes to producing this aircraft, China has been making them since 2007, and Pakistan has been producing them since 2008. However, as for China, interesting fact, they do not fly this aircraft. They make them and ship them to other countries around the world. As a matter of fact, the first full squadron of JF-17s was the number 26 Black Spiders, which became fully formed on February 18th, 2010, with a strength of 14 fighters. And by the way, the Black Spiders is a Pakistan flight squadron. And speaking of Pakistan, it's said that they operate about 99 of these aircraft currently. In combined history though, Pakistan has 101 of these aircrafts. However, a couple of them were lost due to accidents. In 2011, there was an accident where the pilot did not survive. And in 2016, one crashed in the Arabian Sea and the pilot ejected safely. Besides that, the other countries that operate these aircrafts are Nigeria, in which they have 3 of them, and the country of Myanmar, which has purchased 16. Other countries like Azerbaijan has a deal in the works, but other countries like Algeria, Argentina, Egypt, Qatar, Iran, and many others have an interest in this fighter. Now jumping over, let's look at the HAL Tejas. Its first flight was in 2001, however, it wasn't introduced until 2015. But for the history of this aircraft, it goes all the way back to 1983, at least. It was at this time that India realized that they would need to replace their aging MiG-21s. And by 1984, Designs decided to go ahead to build a new fighter for the country. Interesting fact, when it comes to this fighter, a lot of people identify it as the HAL Tejas, but you could theoretically say it's the ADA Tejas, and I'll explain why. The reason for this is many people identify this fighter to be developed by the Hindu Aeronautics Limited. And although that might be true, most of the responsibilities was actually under a company known as ADA, which is simply a consortium company of over 100 different companies, known as the Aeronautical Development Agency. But to skip all that, it was in 1993 that the first phase of this fighter began with a proof of concept and design development testing. Similar to the JF-17, there was also U.S. involvement, such as Lockheed Martin was heavily involved in the development of this fighter. However, in 1998, they ended up pulling out simply due to the fact that India, well, they did second nuclear tests, and the United States really didn't like that. However, with all of that, by 2001, they had several prototypes with a developmental cost of approximately 7,956.56 crore. Testing for this aircraft would go on until 2015, when the IAF ordered 120 of these aircraft. And today, they are considered the new bad boys of the air. And the first full squadron of these for the IAF was the number 45 squadron, known as the Flying Daggers. And they were formed on July 1st, 2016. Now, as for operators, well, pretty much you've only got one country that's operating this aircraft, partially due to the fact that it is brand spanking new, and that is the country of India. And even though they are very careful with this new fighter, they have recently stated that they would allow friendly and neighboring countries to purchase this aircraft. For example, in January of 2019, Malaysia even had interest in this fighter. As for the current number of these, well, it's been said that India has 120 of them on order. Currently, as of 2019, including prototypes, there's only 28 of them made. And keep in mind, when it comes to that 120, I'm not 100% on that because there's some mixed reports. In 2016, they said that India also ordered 83 of them. So I think it's 120, but again, there's some miscommunication in media there. Moving right along, let's take a look at some of the variants of these fighters. So besides its prototypes, the JF-17 has three variants. There is the JF-17 Block 1 and, of course, the Block 2, which has improved avionics, enhanced load carrying, electronic warfare abilities, and much more. Unfortunately, the original one did not have an air refueling capacity, so the Block 2 now has corrected that. There's also the Block 3, which is the most recent, which they added a helmet, mounted display and sight, multi-panel and function display, upgrades to the radar and infrared, and this all came in 2017. On top of that, there's also the JF-17B, which is basically your two-seater version. It has enhanced surveillance abilities and is somewhat used for training. As for the HAL Tejas, when it comes to its variants, there's really only one type of them that is currently in use by militaries. However, there are other variants that have been built or are at least in future plans. Besides the MK-1, the MK or Mark 1A has increased radar, which is the AESA radar, which is developed with Israel. It is also 1,000 kilograms less and is more maintenance friendly. Similar to the JF-17, the first original version did not have the capability to refuel in the air. However, the Mark 1A fixes that. There's also plans for the Mark 1 Navy. This one's to address major naval concerns. And the biggest one is that is way too heavy for the carriers that they have. And it should be able to take off on a small runway. They also have plans for a Mark 2. However, this won't be completed until 2022. It is aimed to have a more powerful engine, which will help with increased payload. And as well, there is radar, infrared upgrades, and onboard oxygen system upgrades as well. So now let's take a look at how these stack up in other particular stats. So looking at length, you've got the JF-17, which is approximately 14.93 meters. You've also got the HAL Tejas, which is 13.20 meters. For its wingspan, the JF-17 is a lot bigger with 9.48 meters, where the Tejas is 8.20 meters. And for height, the JF-17 comes in a little bit bigger at 4.72 meters, where the Tejas is 4.40 meters. Basically, the HAL Tejas is just a little bit smaller, which could be helpful for dogfights or anything like that. As for the max takeoff weight, the JF-17 has 29,750 pounds, whereas the HAL Tejas can have a total of 29,100 pounds. Speed, however, the JF-17 can go to Mach 1.6 and the Tejas can go to Mach 1.8. The service ceiling, however, the JF-17 can go much higher at 55,500 feet, where the Tejas has a ceiling height of 52,500 feet. Now, as for operational range, this is including with drop tanks. The JF-17 can go approximately 1,352 kilometers, where the Tejas can go 1,750 kilometers. For weapons, though, when it comes to these two fighters, ironically enough, they both use the same guns. Because the JF-17 and the HAL Tejas use a 1x23mm twin-barrel cannon, which is known as the GSH-23. Hardpoints, though, this is also where they differ. Basically, your JF-17 can carry 7x4 under wing, 2 under tip, and 1 under the fuselage, meaning that they can carry up to 7 different types of weapons. For example, they can use air-to-air, air-to-surface, and anti-ship, as well an array of different types of bombs from unguided to guided. In total, it can also hold 3 drop tanks and many countermeasures. The HAL Tejas, however, has 8 times hardpoints, 6 on the wing, 1 on the fuselage, and 1 beneath the port side intake trunk. Their armaments include air-to-air, air-to-surface, and air-to-ship missiles, and as for bombs, they can have laser-guided or unguided bombs, and they can also carry drop tanks. And last but not least, the one thing that we gotta look at is the cost of these two fighters. For the JF-17, for its Block 1 original version, it comes in at $25 million USD. However, for its Block 3, although it's not official and it is apparently planned, it is said to cost $32 million USD. HAL Tejas, its original version, is very similar. It sits at $23 million USD. And for the MK1A, for all of its upgrades, it's said to jump way up to $64 million USD. So there you go, guys. That's me looking at the differences between these two fighters. Interesting enough, they are the more modern fighters from these two countries. What are your thoughts on them? Which fighter do you think is better? To be perfectly honest, I mean, I always say it's always down to the pilot, because simply you see old fighters just totally obliterating new ones. It's just kind of, you know, what happens. But I want to know your thoughts. And with that, before you guys get out of here, don't forget to check out the military playlist if you like learning about different military topics. And last but not least, I'm Dave Wapple. Thank you guys for tuning in, and I'll see you guys in the next one, okay? Bye. Here you go, guys. So here are those playlists that I was telling you about. By the way, before you guys get out of here, if you're new here, you want to hit that subscribe button and that bell notification so you can stay in tune with the stuff that we're doing. Other than that, you guys have yourself a fantastic day. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.